Hi guys, what's up? How are you? So today, Italian red wines to pair with food for beginners. So easy peasy. So today we're gonna discover which are some of the best Italian red wines paired with some of the best Italian food, or in general, the best pairings for these Italian red wine that whatever you can drink. So let's start. Stay tuned. Let's go. Okay, so the first red wine I want to talk about is probably one of the most famous one, especially it had a kind of a renaissance in the past few years, 10 years I would say, and it is the Chianti. So everybody knows Chianti, famous Chianti made from Sangiovese mainly. Chianti is a very nice. There are many kind of version of Chianti. So you have the classical, the basic one, then you have the Riserva, then you have the Grand Selection. So I wanted to give you a little overview of some possibilities, and also give you some labels that, in my opinion, can be good for you. So Chianti is a medium body wine, especially if you are drinking the classic version, the normal version. As soon as you go higher in aging, so Riserva, Grand Selection, become a little bit bold. So you move toward a medium body red wine. So, however, let's say that we are talking about now the classic Chianti. And by saying this, I'm not mean the Chianti Classico. Chianti Classico is a specific area. Okay, anyway, so Chianti Classico is a nice red wine with a nice acidity, especially if you're drinking it quite young, with a lot of red fruits, very long persistence, and goes extremely well with the pastas in general. It is in general quite versatile, but I would say that in Italy we pair it with pasta, with ragù or lasagne, for instance. But you can go even with some meat. Pork, for instance, goes very well, or even maybe a roasted chicken. Absolutely outstanding, goes very well. In general, it is quite versatile, so it has a very wide range of pairing. So these are just some few examples for you. So which are some of the greatest labels, in my opinion, you should try for the Chianti, especially now that they came out? So one of my favorite, absolutely, is the Castello Fonterutoli by Mazzei. They produce the whole range of Chiantis, and they are very high in quality. You drink very well, spending also the right amount of money. So good value for money and very high quality. Then another good one is the one from Isola Eolena. Great Chiantis as well. They produce also some Super Tuscan, the same for the Fonterutoli one. And probably there is another one that is really nice, very well made, is the Castello di Ama Chianti Classico, quite famous as well. So they are all in the classical area. That is, in my opinion, is the best one, is the more elegant one. So these are some of my recommendations for the Chianti. Okay, so the second wine I want to talk about, very famous, is the Nebbiolo grape. With the Nebbiolo grape, we make the Barolo, and we make the Barbaresco as well. Plus, there is also the Alta Langhe, Gemme, Gattinara. There are many different ones, but anyway, the two most famous are the Barolo and Barbaresco. So they are, depending even here in which stage you're gonna drink them, but let's say it is the most approachable one, so we are going to the one just released. They have a nice acidity, they are quite lively, and so we need something that is quite fat to pair with, so that we can basically clean the palate easily. Also because they are quite rich in tannin, so Nebbiolo is a quite high tannin grape. So even here, I will go with meat. Here we can increase the body of the dish, so I will go with lamb, for instance. It's perfect, maybe roasted lamb or beef in general. You're drinking very well, or heavy dishes like heavy pasta or heavy risotto with a lot of fat on these dishes. So these lovely Barolo and Barbaresco and Nebbiolo in general works very, very well. Then, as soon as you increase the age, so you go to the Reserva one, so you can even increase the body too. Another good one, maybe with the Nebbiolo, but not age as the Barolo. Maybe I would say for the Barbaresco or a classic Nebbiolo, maybe quite fresh, maybe just that went through just a few months of cask. Could be some pasta with some black truffles that works very, very well, and it's not too punchy, maybe as a Barolo or a Riserva Barbaresco. And because the black truffle is quite intense. So some of the good labels that you can drink. So Barolo, there are so many that is very difficult. My favorite in absolutely is the Canubi Boschis. Absolutely is something in my opinion outstanding. Then you have Verzio from always the Barolo area, and Barbaresco, well, there is Gaia, just to mention the one, there is Giacosa, and they work very well, but they are quite expensive. Anyway, you drink quite well wherever you go in Barolo Barbaresco. Just you have to be careful with the vintages. Vintages are quite important because there is quite a difference between a good vintage and maybe a less good vintage, especially if it rain a lot that year. So that just the only thing you have to be careful. So guys, if you are enjoying the video and the videos and the channel, smash the like button. So click the like and click the subscribe button and the notification bell, so you won't miss any new video coming out. So what can you expect from this channel? So I talk about wine and spirits, greater focus on the wine world because I'm a sommelier and I love the wine world, and I give you tips about how to appreciate and enjoy at their best all these fabulous wines that our earth produce, and the tips where to find hidden wine gems, and also maybe to help you with your studies if you are approaching now the wine studies. So if this is the channel for you, subscribe and give the like and click the notification bell, so this will also help me in making more video and support me a lot. Thank you. Third wine I want to talk about now, it's a little bit less well known compared to the previous two, for instance, and it is the Nerello Mascalese from Etna, from Sicily. And it is quite unique. It is also called the Pinot Noir of the South, and it is very, very well made. I'm gonna describe it to you now. So, the color is quite light as the Pinot Noir. It is not too bold, maybe, so it is like a punchy Pinot Noir, for instance. So it is usually aged a little bit in barrels, but the main feature of this wine that grows in this soil around the volcano Etna is the minerality. So you really feel the crispiness and the minerality of the lava, the volcanic soil in the wine, in the best expression. Plus, you have all these red berries, really, really nice and fresh and lively. So, I put this wine in the medium-bodied category. So, this one goes very, very well with all the pastas, again, especially if you have some ragù or but even some veggie pastas, okay, goes very, very well. Which are some of the best expressions? So, my favorite ones are two. One is Girolamo Russo that really works very, very well, especially Arena is one of my favorite label. And then you have Passo Pisciaro that with all the Contrada, all the vineyards around the Etna has different expressions. Some are a little bit more earthy, some are a little bit more fruitier. But they are really, really outstanding. If you want to try something different, maybe you haven't tried yet, I would recommend you the Nerello Mascalese from Etna. So as I said, so pasta Even chicken, roasted chicken, over a barbecue goes very, very well. And it is extremely, extremely enjoying. So I hope you have the chance to try the Nerello Mascalese. So this was my third recommendation. So the fourth Italian wine I want to talk about is very, very famous. It's the Brunello di Montalcino, made 100% from Sangiovese Grosso. And Brunello di Montalcino, I left there my heart because I went a few years ago and I really had a deep trip. I got to know all the areas, the different areas. But anyway, it is absolutely a place that deserves your attention, in my opinion. Absolutely go to visit Montalcino because it is beautiful, and also all the Chianti Classico area, it's absolutely amazing. Okay, anyway, break it up, close. So what I wanted to say is, so Brunello di Montalcino, even here you have the Brunello di Montalcino, then you have the Riserva. So more it is aged, bolder it is, best expression you have to wait probably a little bit before to drink it. And anyway, even here we are going with some meat here, probably the lamb, roasted lamb, or even roasted pork are very great, especially beef as well, the Fiorentina steak is absolutely fantastic with this Brunello di Montalcino. Brunello di Montalcino live acidity as well, even here, especially when it is young. Very long, persistent, very long finish, nice spiciness, and a lot of these violet floral notes and fruit as well. So absolutely ampious spectrum of aromas, but what is the main feature that you have to keep in mind of the Sangiovese in general, but Montalcino, is the acidity, because Sangiovese is quite lively when it is young. So something that maybe a roasted pork with a bit of fattiness goes very, very well, but steak, Fiorentina steak, if you don't know now, you can see a picture, is absolutely fantastic and you can enjoy it. I do recommend you to decant it here if you drink, especially if it is a young bottle, and open it 2-3 hours. I forgot to tell you, same thing is for the Barolo and the Barbaresco. It is better, in my opinion, to open it a little bit before and then decant it. For the Chianti, that depends in which kind of age you are going. It is not absolutely necessary. And also for the Nerello Mascalese, you can go, just put ampious glasses. So some good expression that you don't have to miss are the one of my favorite is Tenuta le Potazzine. It is a small estate fox only in super quality Brunello. Then there is Biondi Santis, that is the institution basically of the Brunello di Montalcino, that works very, very well. And the Casanova di Neri is another very, very good producer that you shouldn't miss. So the fifth Italian red wine I want to talk now is quite famous. It is the Montepulciano d'Abruzzo. So we are in central east part of Italy. Montepulciano is a late ripening grape that can grow well basically only in this part of Italy, east, south part. If you go to the north, it's a little bit more difficult. And the main feature are these kind of ripe fruits that you can feel in the nose, and then they age a lot. It depends also here which kind of Montepulciano you get, if you get the fresh one or a more aged one. But I would say the best expression are with a little bit of passage in the wood, unless you go for some very good producer that I'm gonna mention now. So here Montepulciano, as I said, a lot of fruit, especially when it is young, if it got through a passage in cask, you have also a bit of spiciness. But what is the main characteristic? The concentration, the textures, it is quite very concentrated and rich in alcohol, okay? So very, very nice. Goes even here very, very well with lamb, I would say roasted lamb, cheeses as well. You drink very, very well these at the end of the meal, maybe with some cheeses. I would say a hard cheese with intense flavor. Or also you can go with some intense and rich pastas with meat, I would say, even here. So absolutely quite versatile also, because even here depends which kind of version you type you get. So there are some more approachable and lighter that they didn't go through the cask. However, my favorite are with a little bit of passage in bar. So some good labels. So you should try Mascarelli. You can try the Villa Gemma if you like a very bold Montepulciano, or the Iskra, it's a little bit less age in barrel. But the best expressions that they didn't go through wood cask too much are Valentini, absolutely outstanding, and Emilio Pepe. So these two are absolutely probably the true most expression. Also, they are made in a natural way, so with natural yeast fermentation. They are unfiltered, organic, possibly biodynamic viticulture as well. So they are very, very well. So obviously they are a bit expensive. So just to keep you in mind. So these are some of the best recommendations for the Montepulciano. So guys, so we went through some of the best Italian red wines that you can find in the market now. So I hope you enjoyed the video. If you want to watch also a video with the top recommendation for the French white wines to pair with food, there are the links in the description below. And please, what is your opinion? So what would you pair with some of these red wines that I mentioned here on this video? Please do let me know in the comments below, so I will be very curious, so we can eventually exchange also some opinions. It would be really, really lovely, my opinion. So I want to thank you for your time. So if you enjoyed the video and you got some value out of it, click the subscribe button so you won't miss any new video. And if you haven't done yet, smash the like, so this will help me with the YouTube algorithm and support me to making more videos. So that is for this video. I hope to see you in the next one. Ciao.